You know, as a kid, my musical influences came from many different places. Now, my dad listened to prog rock, my mom listened to things like Bon Jovi and Air Supply, and my grandparents, they listened to country music. Now, I would replay Shania Twain's The Woman in Me over and over and over again, annoying my mother to no end. And I bet if I did it now, she'd probably have the same reaction. But country music as a kid just kind of gave me such vivid imagery through storytelling that I could just get lost in it. It was good company when I was alone. I eventually moved on to, you know, that post-grunge alt-rock radio stuff. And to this day, that's kind of my comfort and what I like to listen to now. Every so often, songs that I knew kind of get lost to time, but eventually they come back and I'm somewhat pleased to discover them for a second time. David Lee Murphy's Dust on the Bottle is certainly one of those songs. I went back, revisited and listened to this song after at least 20 years, and oh my God, does this song stand up just as well as it did in like 1994 when it was released. The beat is reminiscent of Queen's We Will Rock You, and the twangy guitars open up playing the chorus melody, which really solidify the hook. Now, David Lee Murphy is a guitar player, so there's no surprise that there are two guitar solos in this song. I think they really elevate the song, and aside from those solos in the bridge, the music is very consistent and simplistic, which really helps the lyrical story shine through. The production is fantastic, and honestly, I do not feel like this came out in 1994 or 1995. That is just completely wild to me because it sounds modern without singing about babes, beaches, and Ford trucks. I love that the lyrics paint a picture for me without explaining the entire idea. The story is split into two verses and one bridge, only involves three easily defined characters, and is roughly outlined as... So the narrator goes to his neighbor's house looking for a bottle of homemade wine, because that neighbor is like really good at making homemade wine, and he wants to show off to this girl that he's seeing, and he wants to give her some of this wine. Now, this song is being sung directly to her, because later on in the song he says you, so clearly he's singing to her. So the narrator and this neighbor, which they call Creole Williams, they go down into the cellar, and Creole explains that although the bottle of wine is caked in dust, trust that the contents are still sweet, still good, good to go. The narrator takes a bottle of wine, goes to pick up his lady, they get into the vehicle, and they go drive off to watch the sunset together. Now, during the bridge, he talks to his lady and says that now we've been together for X amount of time, we've made some memories. Some say good love is like a fine wine, keeps getting better as the days go by. And even just saying that, it just like makes me want to tear up emotionally, because I think that's just like the sweetest idea. And this analogy is, it's very obvious through the song, and it is just the cutest thing. And apparently it only took like 15 minutes to write this song, and I definitely believe it. And I bet that he was just sitting there at his kitchen table, just looking at a dusty bottle of wine, and just the whole story just wrote itself. Now, I don't know if that's actually what happened, but I mean, I can imagine it's not too far-fetched. And I've just always liked this song because of the imagery it provides. It's really easy to follow, and it paints a picture that helps me remember the words. Because if you know how a story is going to go, you know what's going to come up next, what's going to happen. So you can kind of know what verse you're singing. Although there's literally only two verses, one bridge, and maybe three choruses. Maybe four because he doubles up at the end. Dust on the Bottle, for me, gets an A+. And now that I think about it, I think I love this song much more than I thought I did. I've had to listen to it continuously for a few days while I write this, and right now, I want to hear it again, and again, and it's playing in my head as I speak. Dust on the Bottle will never grow old, will never bore me, and will never cease to demonstrate how such a simple and quickly written song can be so good. And that is why I love this song.